गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर धवल चंद राणा एंड गाइज वी विल कंटिन्यू यूनिट नंबर 4 नोन एज इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ साइबर क्राइम एंड लॉ ऑफ साइबर क्राइम. एज प्रीवियसली वी विल डिस्कस टू डिफरेंट वीडियोज ऑन अ यूनिट नंबर 4. फर्स्ट वन वी आर डिस्कस सम बेसिक फंडामेंटल थिंग्स ऑफ अ साइबर क्राइम, वॉट इज अ साइबर क्राइम एंड हाउ इट शुड बी हैपनिंग. ऑन अ सेकेंड वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंट classifications of cyber crime. So in previous two video we are just focusing on a cyber crime. So guys, now onwards we are focusing on the third thing, which is part of unit number 4 known as a cyber criminal works, means how they are performing a cyber crimes. Second point which we discuss in the today's video lecture, it is known as a what is a cyber law. If sub cyber crime it should be happen to us or to a societies, so what are the different law it should be available in a Indian cyber crime. So just we know that what are the different cyber law is available and how we use this cyber law against the cyber crime. And the third thing which we are discuss in today's video lecture, it is known as a objective of the Information Technology Act. So we will start with the how cyber criminal works. Cyber crime has become the professionals, or we can say it is one of the intellectual activities, and the demography of the cyber criminals is changing rapidly with the types of organized gangsters who are more traditional associated with drug trafficking, extortions and money laundering. Because is all the thing which should be happened in past case, now also it should be happened, but currently they are focusing on a cyber crime, because it happening with only in a single room, they are never going to outside and they are accessing all the data, and they can more reward compared with the drug trafficking, extortions and money laundering. So in a now's own word, cybercrime, it is the peak point on a current global requirement. The questions of how to obtain a credit card bank account data can be answered by the selections of method, each involving their own relative combinations of risk, expenses and skill. As previously we'll discuss the different classification of cybercrime, through which we know that internet fraud, it is part of credit card and bank account data. So they are really intelligent, they are a professions, and they are the gangsters who can taking our credit card or bank account data with his or her smartness, through which all the data should be part of credit card and bank account, they can really use it and transfer a money to our account, to his or her personal account, without knowing us. It is known as a cyber crime. The problem marketplace for this transaction is a hidden internet relay chat, or we can say chat room. Gaining the control of a bank account is increasingly accomplished through the phishing. Guys, as previously we will discuss internet theft, at that time I will just give you the one example of internet theft, it known as a phishing. Phishing is the one of the biggest cyber crime now the day, because they are just doing the same web pages which should be actual one or which is a legal organization. They just redirect to our data with a username and password. If some users provide his or her actual username and password, so they can directly access it within a 2 minutes, not more than 2 minutes, within a 2 minutes they can transferring amount whatever it should be happening a particular personal account, because the only activity should be performed within the single room, they are never going to the outside of room. So that's why cybercrime, it is one of the biggest crime in now the era. What is a cyber law? If, as previously, which we have seen lots of cybercrime, इफ एनी ऑफ द क्राइम शुड बी हैपन विथ अस और विथ अवर सोसाइटी, सो व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट लॉ इज अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट द साइबर क्राइम. सो वी जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस डिफरेंट साइबर लॉज. साइबर लॉ इन इंडिया इज अ नॉट अ सेपरेट लीगल फ्रेमवर्क. इट्स अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी, डेटा प्रोटेक्शन एंड प्राइवेसी लॉ. मीन्स देर आर नो एडिशनल लीगल फ्रेमवर्क विच वी मैंशंस दैट इट इज अ साइबर लॉ, बट दे आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स, इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टीज, डेटा प्रोटेक्शन एंड प्राइवेसी. द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दोस ऑल द थिंग्स विच शुड बी पार्ट ऑफ साइबर लॉ. वॉट इज कॉन्ट्रैक्ट? वेन वी आर इंस्टॉलिंग द सम सॉफ्टवेयर एट दैट टाइम दे टेक अ सम परमिशंस. We never read all the data which should be in a small character and lots of line. We just direct accept and provide a next button. In this all the information they can take lots of contracts with us, but we are not interested because we are interesting to a freeware software. So that's why it is the problem of cybercrime. With the computer and internet taking over the every aspect of our life, there was need to be a strong cyber law. As previous we will discuss, if we are taking any of the new product in our home, we directly put a story on social media. If we are going to outside, we directly put a status, we are performing this kind of things. So all the thing should be happening on internet and someone who can directly access our this kind of information. Cyber law survives the digital circumstances of information, software, information security, e-commerce and monetary transactions. Whenever we perform any of the activity through the cyber laws, they are providing security against the digital circulations of information, software, if any of the software perform and the damage of our data, they provide a law against the cyber security. Information security, if someone access our data without any authentication or authorization, there are built some cyber law against the cyber security. E-commerce, nowadays we are lots of online shopping, it is part of a e-commerce. Like Amazon, Paytm, Zomato, Swiggy, all the applications, all the website, it should be part of e-commerce. So if through which, if they can leak our informations, leak of our data, leak of our home address, mobile number and our personal informations, so we can directly go through the cyber law and the monetary transactions. Monetary transactions means if someone access our informations illegally, through which they can misuse our data and through which they can perform cyber crime. So for that kind all the activity whenever this should be performed and some cyber crime should be happened through these informations, the cyber law is available for us. The Information Technology Act 2000 addresses the gamuts of new age crimes. Means in a legal case, the Indian have produced a Information Technology Act 2000 against the cyber crime. Computer technology, mobile device, software and the internet are both the medium and the targeted of such kind of crimes. Or we can say in a previous basic fundamental of cybercrime, at that time we are discussing all kind of electric media which should be either targeted or which should be used for the cybercrime. So that's why is it any of the things which should be happen to accessing our information through which technologies, or if they're taking some information through which devices, it is both the thing, it should be a cybercrime. All traditional criminal activity are such as theft, fraud, forensic, defamations and mischiefs are part of cyberspace. All the traditional criminal activity means if some cyber crime, it should be happening with us. They are performing some of the activity which should be mentioned is below, known as a theft, fraud, forgery, demutations, and mischiefs are the part of cyber crime. So whenever this kind of activity should be performed on personal computer or in our society, at that time we know that it is known as a cyber crime. Now, how to evaluations of cyber law in India? Because we need to know that what are the different law is available in part of our country. With an increase in the dependency on the use of technology, the need for cyber law was necessary, because nowadays we are using more and more technocrats. Much like every coin has a two sides, therefore, because lots of work are doing the best way to use of latest technology, but if we are using some latest technology, the cyber crime activity should be more and more increasing. That's why I will just mention that much like every coin has a two sides, therefore the dependency on technology has its pros and cons. Means if we are use a technology on a day-to-day life, there are lots of advantages, as well as we never compromise that a technology have a disadvantages. The rise in a 21st century marked the evolutions of cyber law in India with the Information Technology Act 2000, popular known as IT Act. In a 21st century, there are lots of technology we are using in our regular day-to-day life. So lots of crime happening in India. That's why a Indian government introduced IT Act, known as the Information Technology Act 2000. The first ever cyber crime was recorded in the year 1820. I think you are shocked, because the first cyber crime was recorded in 1820, and the law should be produced on a market on 21st century. Objective of Information Technology Act. What are the different objectives? Means why they are introducing this IT Act? To provide a legal recognition for the all the e-transactions. Because before this introductions of IT Act, there are no any kind of legal documents, legal procedures against the e-transactions, against the cyber crimes. So lots of people are confused about they are generate any kind of complaints against the e-transactions. That's why government introduced an Information Act, through which all the normal people also aware about the cyber crimes, and if it should be happen with those kind of people who are not aware about the cyber crime, they are just going through this act and performing the and given the some informations through which they can submit his or her request, like we can say FIR against this particular crime. To give a legal recognition to a digital signature as a valid signature to accept the agreements online. I think you all know aware about a digital signature. So many bill will be generated by electronic mails, as well as electronic fundamental things, like if we are purchasing any kind of online product, they provide e-bills, and on the right hand corner they provide a digital signature and mentions one line that this bill is generated by computers, never required a signature, because they are providing some alphanumeric combination for to identify this particular bill is a legal bill. That's why a digital signature is more recommended nowadays. To give a legal recognition to keeping accounting book in electronic form by bankers as well as other organization, because if a legal information is into the market of cyber crime, all one can access it and perform some legal aspect to this Legal Information Act. Protection of online privacy and stopping the cyber crime, because government generate some guidance against a cyber crime, what are the different types of crime, and if you want to secure by yourself, then how to protect ourselves against the cybercrime. So that's why some of the points crime should be decreasing. Second objectives, it is known the Indian IT law updated, the Reserve Bank of Indian Act and the Indian Evidence Act. With the evaluations of cyber law, almost all the online activity came under the scrutiny. Means, after generating all the laws based on previous past history, they are building some IT laws. Based on the IT laws, all the activity should be performed on throughout the internet. They are based on under the scrutiny. So the activity should be take some order. However, one thing about the cyber law is that there are certain area on which cyber crime law in India do not apply. Means now's on day also some activity should be performed online, but we are not take a part on a cyber crime law. What are the different activities should not part of right now in Indian Information Act? First thing is negotiable instrumental being other than checks. Negotiable instrument means some second-handed products like OLX. OLX is the legal thing, but in somehow if we purchase a second-hand things on the throughout the market, on the throughout the internet, it is not take part of ITX. Second, power of authority means someone provides some authority to generate some another person to authority. It is known as a power of attorney. Like a CEO of company, it is one of the authority to take all the decision about the organization, but it is not part of IT Act. Will means some nominee about his or her child, it is not part of Information Technology Act. The contract for sales on convince of inoperable properties, or we can say immovable properties. The contract for sales means purchasing some house, purchasing some second hand house, as well as rent house, PGs, all the things which should be part of conveyancing of immovable properties. At that time, Indian IT Act, it not take a part of a cybercrime act. And the last one, central government notifies documents or transactions. Means those kind of notices which are part of central governments, if some crime should be happening through this notified document or transaction, it is never part of Information Act. So it's a list of five different things which is not take a part right now in Information Act. So guys, it is the way how the Information Act or IT Act 2000, which we are seeing in a brief idea, what are the different crimes, how the criminal behave like it, and if some activity should be happened, then what are the different act is available in India. So it is up to now, we have stopped this lecture through this objective of Information Technology Act. I think I enjoy it. Thank you so much.